Well, 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 hello. Welcome to my channel. I am in a great mood. I'm so excited for this video today. So we are fresh faced because we're gonna be trying a few products that have been in my collection for a while. And as I've been shopping my stash recently, I was like, you know what? I feel like it's been a long time since I've used those and they were expensive. So I wanna remind myself of how I feel about them and decide, you know, should I keep them? Are they worth keeping? Should I pass them on? So a lot of these are products I know that I like. It's just been a long time and I'm like, why am I not reaching for it? What is it about those products that has me reaching for other things over it? Does that make sense? Okay. This top is from Amazon. And I bought it because I saw Danny from Coffee Break with Danny wearing it. And I was like, oh, I love it. So literally I bought it from her link and here we are. So thanks Danny for being a fashion icon. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 products we're gonna retry today. I guess I should pull my hair back. So the first thing I wanted to retry, I'm already moisturized and stuff like that, is this SPF. It's from Tatcha. I bought it not even that long ago at Sephora. And I thought, I like a lot of Tatcha products. Like I'm always using the same SPFs that I love. Nothing wrong with that. But I figured maybe I would branch out and try something else. Well, A, this was expensive, but I liked the idea that it said it was pore perfecting. It's SPF 35. Here was the problem. The few times I used it at the beginning, I discovered that it would pill up underneath makeup. I reused this, I wanna say 2 weeks ago, and I found out a trick that works and I wanna try it again today to see if it works again. I really hope it works. What I did was I applied it and I let it sit for like a few minutes. So I went ahead and put it on. It definitely has a sunscreen smell, but I put it on and I literally let it sit on my face. And I think that's the key because I think I tried to go straight in with something else right away. And it was too soon. Like it just needed that time to kind of sink into my face so it wouldn't move around. So start the clock. We're just gonna sit in silence for 5 minutes. I'm just kidding. But it definitely has that white look to it. So I do wonder, I have a feeling this would give a little bit of flashback if you're concerned about that. It's not really something I'm super concerned about because frankly, I'm not often photographed in flash photography. I feel like that used to be a really big problem for me. Like I would worry about that, but I'm like, why, when am I ever getting my photo taken with flash? So while we're waiting, does anyone else, I get driven crazy. I'll see like an ad on Facebook or whatever for a really cute like dress or top and I'm like, oh. So I'll click it and I'll be like, oh, I wanna get that. And then when I go through to actually like purchase it, it is always sold out. I'm like, this has happened like 4 times in the past month. Probably a good thing because it's preventing me from buying it. But I'm like, stop advertising your cute sold out stuff. All right, let me check my timer. I set a timer for 5 minutes. We've got 2 more minutes. Turn it off. That's my alarm sound too. So anytime I hear it, I'm like, I gotta wake up. Wait. So it feels nice and set. I set it for like 5 minutes, like I said. And so we're just gonna try. Here's the deal. I mean, this is expensive. I do feel like my skin doesn't look like greasy from it or anything like that, but this is expensive and it's finicky. So would I say, yeah, go out and buy it? I don't think so. Would I buy this again? I don't think so, but I do want to at least use it up. So there's the info on that. Here's a product that I wanna say a year ago, I really, really liked. I remembered loving this and I used it for a few months after that video and then it just got kind of shoved in my drawer and I didn't ever grab for it again. The Clarins SOS Primer. This is the one that's like the lavender and it says it visibly brightens sallow skin. I really liked this. Like you will see, I'm gonna do it on half my face. You'll see it really does brighten. And I feel like a lot of times my skin needs that brightness help. I know other people really like other primers from them. So we're gonna see like the other different shades. I would wonder if this would look ashy if you had darker skin though. That's one thing I've wondered about that, you know? I think I put too much on honestly, but let's just see. You can see that it definitely brightened my skin. Like you can definitely see, at least in my opinion, a slight difference. But I've been talking to you guys a lot about how like a lot of us just skip primer, right? Because it's one of those steps that unless you're seeing a huge difference underneath whatever you're wearing, foundation, BB cream, whatever, it feels like a step that's so easy to cut if you're pressed for time, which most of us are in the morning for whatever reason, whether it's trying to get ready before work or because you have kids or for school. I like it. It definitely has a little bit of a scent, not one that lingers long. So if that bothers you, I feel like, especially if you're someone that really feels like your skin just is missing that, I don't wanna say glow, because this I don't think at all gives you a glow, but if you just feel like your skin is lackluster, you really might like this. I don't know that this is a step that I feel like makes such a difference now that I'm, you know, seeing it again with fresh eyes, if you will, that actually I did put in new contacts today. So my eyes are like super fresh. We'll see if I end up using it now that I'm kind of rediscovering it anymore. I do think it does what it says. I think it's nice, but if you're not a primer person, I wouldn't say to run out and buy it. Here's the thing I'm really, really excited to retry. It's been a hot minute. This is the Josie Maran Vibrancy Foundation. This is one that when I first tried it, it is super, super dewy. At least that's what I remembered. So I would use it here and there. And especially like right now it's winter. I'm like, I feel like this would be a good time for me to use it when my skin's a little bit drier. I have the shade RG10 and I'm gonna apply it with the Paw Paw blender. It's like the $1.50 blender. It's just super glowy. So we're gonna see. I think the sponge will be good to kind of help like tone things down. I don't know, we're just gonna see. But I remembered it having pretty darn good coverage too. That might've been too much. We'll just spread it across. It's so pretty though. Like, I feel like my skin when I put this on, why am I not reaching for this? Oh my gosh. This is why I was so excited to do this video, because I was like, I want to rediscover and re-fall in love with products that I remembered liking. Okay, so no foundation, foundation. Actually, that shade match is like dead on. But I just feel like my skin looks healthy. Okay, this is not nearly as dewy as I remembered it being. I mean, it's definitely glowy. If you have oily skin, run the other direction from this foundation because you will not like it. But man, if you have normal to dry skin, especially, I think the sponge is the key because I've applied this with my fingers too dewy. I applied it with a brush. Frankly, I just don't love applying foundation with brushes. So for me, I kind of knew that wouldn't. But man, the sponge just kind of tones it down just enough where it just looks so freaking healthy. Now, we are gonna powder it today because there's no doubt that with something like this, you just need that powder layer to kind of, it shouldn't take away all of the glow, but just to make sure it's not sliding around. And I can definitely do a check-in at the end of the day. It's just now hitting me. I haven't done a video where I needed a check-in in a while, but I'll do a check-in at the end of the day. We'll see how all this is wearing because I am curious with how kind of moisturizing this foundation is, but I am loving the look of this. Holy moly. Next up is the CoverFX Power Play Concealer. This is one that's just sitting in my drawer and I actually know that I really like this concealer. And so I'm like, I don't want this to go bad. I want to use this up. So I have the shade P Light 2. It's got a kind of weird applicator. I don't mind it, but it's just like a sphere at the end. A little bit goes a long way. That's probably too much, but I do kind of want to spread it out. And what I've realized about this and quite a few other concealers I like to use is to just let it sit for 45 seconds to kind of, I feel like it stays in place a little bit better once you actually start blending it. But this, I remembered had like really nice medium. You could build it up to full, but I would consider this kind of medium coverage, comfortable to wear. It stays in place pretty well. Concealers are so tricky. I mean, every concealer will go into my fine lines and that's fine. But I just feel like concealers can be so tricky because some of them are just a little bit too drying or they're just too moisturizing where they slide around, but this one was perfectly in the middle. I just can't get over how much I like this foundation. I'm excited. See, now this is what I needed. I needed that reminder of what really good stuff is already in my collection, you know? So I'm just using my Sephora number 56 brush. Depending on when you're watching this, this might still be on sale. They were like all like freaking 50% off or something crazy. All the Sephora Pro brushes. By the way, the SPF didn't pill up. What an exciting day. So maybe that's the key, just let it sit for a little bit. But yeah, it covers a lot. I haven't been sleeping well the past day or two, so I feel like I've just had like extra bags under my eyes, just extra baggage. And I just feel like this covers it pretty well. So I've been recently taking my sponge and once I've blended it in, just kind of soaking up the excess product with this, kind of blending it just a little bit better. It's not perfect. Look at this pour. I'm so tired, you guys. I just added a little bit of lip oil. My lips are so dry right now. I've like did not drink enough water the past few days either. So here we are. Next thing that's been sitting in my drawer for like 5 months is the MAC Mineralized Skin Finish Natural. I have the shade Light Plus, which is a pretty good shade match for me. Got a little bit of coverage, it sets things down, but it just sits in my drawer and that makes me sad. So we're just gonna powder my whole face with it. I don't wanna go crazy because I still want a little bit of that dewiness, but I definitely need to set my T-zone. And then actually, I think I'll even use this. I don't know if I've set my under eyes with this before, but I'm kind of curious and I definitely need to set that. So we'll set my under eye with it. And I actually am gonna go ahead and set back here because I don't always put powder, but one trick I've talked about a little bit lately is using, if I'm gonna use some cream products on my face, having powder underneath it actually has helped with the longevity of it, which has been mind-blowing. It doesn't make sense to me, but it's been working, so I'm not gonna mess with it. So, like I said, it's got a nice kind of satiny finish. You can still see a little bit of that foundation underneath. I think the coverage is nice. It's not overly high coverage, but there's definitely a little bit there. So if sometimes you feel like powder foundations are too much coverage for you, this is a really good medium. I honestly don't remember how I feel about this. This is the NARS Liquid Blush. It's in the shade Orgasm, and I'm so curious because I just feel like I overlook it because it's so liquid, but I do like these kinds of blushes. So I'm just gonna squirt a little bit, do a few dots, that might even be too much, and then use just a stippling brush to kind of, ooh, feel like you have to move really quick. Too much, too much, too much. So I'm grabbing my sponge real fast with a little bit of foundation and concealer on it. That's so much better. Okay. That looks so pretty. So I do think you need to work quickly, and having a moist sponge on hand is probably the key. Yeah, I don't think you can like wait to blend this. This is like a go right away. But the color is pretty. I feel like it would be pretty on a lot of different skin tones. We'll see how well it lasts, you know? Very springy in my opinion. I think that's pretty. Definitely a little finicky in that you wanna blend it right away. And you could just skip the stippling brush altogether. You could just go in with your sponge and do it. I think fingers, you might really want a little bit. That would be a little more tricky to do, but it's possible. So the next one is this Charlotte Tilbury Duo. I used to love this. I use it all the time, but it's just sitting in there because I'm using other things. But I remembered it being incredible. And this is like a holy grail, like so many people have talked about this for years. But it's the Filmstar Bronze and Glow Duo. So there's like a bronzer and a highlight. I have it in the shade. I'm sure I have it like in the lightest one. Cause I think, yeah, for fair to medium skin. So we're gonna use both of these. We're gonna go in with the bronzer first, the sculpting side. And I'm just gonna kind of focus it back there and a little bit up here. It's a nice shade if you're near my skin tone, I think, for bronzer, where it's not super ruddy, it's not super orange. It just kind of looks nice and a little bit natural, almost contour-esque, you know what I mean, shade-wise. But I like it. I feel like it's pretty forgiving, it's pretty easy to blend, and it adds just that little bit of bronziness you might want. For my highlight, I'm just using, it's like a little Milani one I've had for a while, I actually really like. Gonna get the highlight shade here. This one I remembered liking because, I just realized I haven't done my brows or eyes. I really liked this because it looks very, for a powder highlight, it looks kind of natural. It's definitely glowy, but it doesn't like emphasize texture. And that's one reason I think a lot of people like it. That's definitely one reason I like it. See, I'm excited to use this. Doesn't that look so nice? So let me go ahead and finish the rest of my makeup and I will pop back in. All right, figured I would show you it in natural light now that I've completed my makeup. I love this foundation. I will say this, I have had to three different times already that concealer, using the MAC powder to set the concealer, it's just not setting it. It's not that type of powder. So I feel like it didn't really do the job well there. So that's not a powder I would recommend. I just never used it that way, honestly. But I feel like the foundation is showing really nicely, even in natural daylight. I don't know, man. By the way, I use my LA Girl brow pencil for my brows. On the eyes, I use the Charlotte Tilbury Quad in Pillow Talk. I love that. I use all four shades. And then the liner I use is the Maybelline Gel liner. And then I topped it with the Renaissance Flick liner from Revolution. And then I use the Thrive Cosmetics mascara. I do need to put a lip product on. I still just have the lip oil. But I just figured I would show you this. So I will check in at the end of the day. We will see how all of the rest of this is wearing. All right, so it is now a little after 10. I've had this on for almost 12 hours. Okay, some thoughts. So first thing, I've got my like little close-up mirror here. First thing, foundation. I can't wait to use that again. I feel like it might be one of those foundations that, like I mentioned earlier, oily skin, forget about it, no freaking way. I think you would absolutely hate it. But if you have normal to dry, I just think it looks so healthy and nice. Like I was, okay, it was Bachelor night, the night I'm filming this. So we were watching The Bachelor and literally I'm like rubbing my forehead and stuff. And I feel like it still looks okay. My skin doesn't look overly oily like I think that I thought it would. However, the powder, the MAC powder, I don't know that I love. I think if I'm gonna do a powder, I either want it to have even higher coverage
or I want it to just be like a loose translucent powder. I feel like that in between is just not my favorite, and that's probably why I stopped reaching for it. I don't think the powder itself is bad. It obviously mattified enough, and maybe that is the reason that the foundation didn't get crazy oily. I'll have to kind of experiment, but it's just one of those things that I'll probably continue to use it for a while, but I don't think I would buy it again. Concealer-wise, I think it did a pretty darn good job. Like I said, that's a concealer I knew I liked. I just hadn't really been reaching for. Medium coverage, it stayed pretty well. Definitely needs to be set with a really good under eye setting powder. The blush, that along with the foundation were probably the two standouts for me. It might not be, I don't know how well it's dark out. So this is like the best lighting I've got other than studio lighting. And that I think that washes it out a little bit more. I think the blush lasted really well. While it was finicky to apply and you have to kind of be quick with it. And I don't want to scare you. You don't have to be that quick. You've got time. But just knowing that about it, it lasted better than most cream blushes that I use. Even some of my favorites, like the Flower Beauty. I feel like that one lasts pretty well, but this one I think lasted longer considering, like I said, I was rubbing my face. It looks just the way it did when I first applied. So I really like that. I'm definitely gonna use that again. The bronzer and highlighter, you can definitely still see the highlight. I think it looks pretty and natural. I even put it on my brow bone there. I just like the highlight. I think the bronzer, if I had to pick a favorite out of that little duo, I think I like the highlight better than the bronzer, but I do really like the bronzer because, as I mentioned, it's kind of that in-between shade. I don't think it lasted a crazy amount of time. There's still a little bit there. Oh my gosh, editing future Jessie here. Forgot to mention the primer and the sunscreen in my check-in. Obviously, it's a different day. The sunscreen, like I said, it didn't peel up, so I think it's fine. I still wouldn't recommend because it is finicky and it's $65 freaking dollars. I can't believe I spent that much on a freaking sunscreen. And then the primer, that's one that I was looking at just today. I was kind of putting it away and I was like, I do like it. And like I said, I think for a very specific subset of people, if you're someone that you feel like you do need a little bit of brightness, but not glow, you might really like it. But it's one of those steps that I could see myself eventually decluttering that, knowing that it's a step that I don't feel like I personally need every single day. Anyway, I'm overall impressed. I feel like I need to do this kind of a video every like 4 or 5 months to remind myself that there are other products in my collection I do love and that I should use because most of them I did spend my own money on. So just a lesson for me, if you are someone that you have a large collection, you feel like, you know, there's a lot of things just sitting there and you're not sure how you feel or whatever, pull them out. Challenge yourself to use them this week. You might re-fall in love with something. You might realize you actually don't like it and you can pass it on. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you guys so much for watching. It means so much to me. Give this video a thumbs up if you like this style. And other than that, I'll catch you guys in my next one. Bye.